All right, so in this section, we're going to discuss statements, negations, and quantified statements. So basically what we're doing here is we're giving you a very brief or basic introduction to what's called symbolic logic, just some basic ideas of logic. And in doing that, part of, I would say, the most important thing is getting used to the symbols and just understanding some of the basic terminology. So let's go ahead and get started. So first of all, a statement is a sentence that's either true or false, but not both simultaneously. So for example, Dr. Linda Brady is our school president. So at Brookhaven Community College, that would be true. And another example, Dallas is the capital of Texas. And hopefully everybody knows that is false. It would actually be Austin. Next it says, some sentences such as commands, questions, and opinions are not statements because they cannot be established as true or false. So on number one here, it says, which of the following are statements? I would encourage you to try these and then check my answers. So on A, it says, ice cream is the best dessert. And I would wholeheartedly agree, but this is not a statement, and the reason why is because this is an opinion. Letter B, are you hungry? Well, that's certainly not, because that would be a question. Letter C, no Hollywood actor has ever become the president of the United States. Now, this is certainly either true or false. I happen to know that it's false because Ronald Reagan was a Hollywood actor who did become president of the United States, but this is a statement. And then finally, on letter D, do your homework. Well, that's not a statement. That would be a command. And so now let's move on. It says, in symbolic logic, we use letters such as P, Q, R, and S to represent statements. So here we have P with a colon. That's just statement P, which says, Mr. Smith teaches English. Well, I'm Mr. Smith, and I don't teach English. I actually teach math. So for me, at least, or in this situation, this is a false statement. The statement Q is LeBron James is not a professional tennis player. And that's actually a true statement. He is actually a professional basketball player. All right, let's move on. So the negation of a statement has a meaning that is opposite that of the original statement. If P is a statement, then not P is its negation. And we would write it this way. We say either not P, or sometimes people will say tilde P, because that's the tilde symbol. We're just going to use the words not P to describe that symbol, or that set of symbols. So let's go ahead and look at number two. It says, form the negation of each statement. Mr. Smith teaches English. So I want to write a statement that has the opposite meaning. Well, the easiest way to do that is to say, Mr. Smith does not teach English. Now there's another way. You can always create a negation from any statement. You just lead with these words. It is not the case that Mr. Smith teaches English. So these are two ways to write the negation. Again, I believe the first one's probably the most natural way. On part, I would encourage you to go ahead and write two similar statements for part B. Okay, so LeBron James is not a professional tennis player. To negate that, we would say LeBron James is a professional tennis player. Now, the other way to do it is like I did up above. It is not the case that LeBron James is not a professional tennis player. So either of these are correct, but the second one here is actually a double negative, and I think most people would prefer the first choice. So look at number three here. It says, let P and Q represent the following statements. So statement P is, today is not Friday. Now, depending on what day you're reading this, this could be true or false. And statement Q, a tornado hit Dallas this month. Well, the last time I taught this topic, that was a true statement, but that's not currently true. Notice here it says, express each of the following statements symbolically. So today is Friday has the opposite meaning of statement P, which says today is not Friday. So we would just write not P. It's the negation of statement P. On part B, it says, it is not true that a tornado hit Dallas this month. So again, this is negating statement Q, which says a tornado hit Dallas this month. So this is just not Q. All right, let's move on. So now we're going to talk about quantified statements. The words all, some, and no, or sometimes we use the word none, are called quantifiers. A statement containing one of these words is called a quantified statement. So here's some examples of quantified statements. All Texans love football. Some people eat liver. No dogs are cats. And some students do not work hard. So in the table, notice it says these are equivalent ways of expressing quantified statements. So we're going to look at the two different ways, and then I gave an example of each. So all A are B is equivalent to there are no A that are not B. So let's see if this makes sense with an actual statement. Does it seem that it would be equivalent, all Texans love football, would that be equivalent to there are no Texans that do not love football? Well, if all Texans love football, that means there are no exceptions. And that's really what we're saying here. There are no Texans that do not love football. So those are equivalent. The second one, some A are B, is equivalent to there is at least one A that is a B. So for example, if we say some people like liver, that tells me there's at least one person out there that likes liver, believe it or not. I'm not one of them. So some people like liver indicates there's at least one, and in fact, that's the other way we can say this. There is at least one person who likes liver. Don't ask me who. The next statement, no A or B, can equivalently be written as all A or not B. So if we say no dogs are cats, that means there's not even one dog that's a cat. And equivalently, we could say all dogs are not cats. So these both have the same meaning. Last one, some A are not B. Equivalently, not all A are B. So again, let's look at an example and see if this makes sense. Some students do not work hard. Well, that indicates that there's at least one student that does not work hard. So the next statement says, not all students work hard. So again, that would indicate there's at least one that doesn't. And so these have the same basic meaning. All right, let's move on now and talk about how we're going to negate quantified statements. So we're going to negate two statements, and in the process, I'm also going to use Venn diagrams to represent each statement and its negation. So first of all, it says here, all Texans love football. Now, you could probably draw a Venn diagram for that. If you want to try it first, you can. So you should have gotten a picture that looks like this. All Texans love football. So we have Texans, and we have people that love football, or I'm just calling them football lovers. And you can see that all the Texans are inside the football lovers circle. Or even you could say Texans are a proper subset of the football lovers. So all Texans love football. That means there are no exceptions. The negation. So think about this. If we want to negate all Texans love football, all we need to do is just find one that doesn't. And notice that's what the negation is saying. Some Texans do not love football, or there's at least one Texan that doesn't love football. So here's a diagram for that. You've got your Texans and your football lovers, and there's one person in here, at least, that doesn't love football. Anybody in this region would be Texans who don't love football. All right, so let's look at the next one. Some dogs eat vegetables. I happen to know one. My son's dog loves carrots. So a picture of that would look like this. So basically, there's overlap here. You have the circle of all dogs and the circle that indicates all the veggie eaters. And you could see there's at least one in the middle there, so we can say some dogs eat vegetables. There's some, at least one dog that's in both circles. So to negate that, we would basically have to indicate that there's not even one dog that eats vegetables. And notice our negation is, and the negation is exactly that. No dogs eat vegetables. And there's your visual for that one. All right, so we're going to be using this diagram down below to help us because we're going to now write some negations, and this diagram will be nice and helpful as you learn how to do that. But eventually, you're going to have to be able to do this without the diagram. All right, so let's go ahead and move on to the next page and practice. Says, write the negation of each of the following. So our first question, our first statement is all humans are mortal. That means we all die. So I know that's not the most exciting concept here, but so we need to negate that. So let me go ahead and put down that little diagram. So in this case, we have all are, so that's this case here. So to negate it, we're going to use a some statement. So it would be some humans are not mortal. Now let me erase this before I put the answer down. So some humans are not mortal. So all A are B, all humans are mortal. The negation would be some A are not B, or some humans are not mortal. All right, so I've got three more problems I'd like you to try. I would encourage you to try to do them first using this little diagram, and then let's see how you do. So here they are. All right, so let's go ahead and look at these. Some students do not come to class prepared. So that would actually be this statement here. So we're going to write an all statement. All students do come to class prepared. All students do, or just you could just say come to class prepared. All right, let's try the next one. So this is a some statement. Some Texans need therapy. Think that's probably true. Let's see. So that would be this statement here. So to negate it, we would say no Texans need therapy. So again, let me erase this. And no Texans need therapy. And let's move on to number four. It says no students like disco. That's this kind of statement here, no A or B. So we're going to use a statement, some A or B. So in this case, some students, let me erase these, some students like disco. Now, I remember way back in the 70s where we used to do the disco. I remember doing it at a junior high dance, but I don't think most students are into the disco these days. All right, anyway, before we wrap things up here, I just want to point something out here, a couple things. So let's look at number one. All humans are mortal. Well, to negate that, we need to indicate that there's at least one that's not. So when we say some humans are not mortal, That's what we're doing. We're saying there's at least one that's not. Number two, some students do not come to class prepared. That means there's at least one that doesn't come to class prepared. So to negate that, we would say all students come to class prepared, no exceptions. Number three, some Texans need therapy. That means there's at least one. To negate that, we would say no Texans need therapy. There are no exceptions. Number four, no students like disco. That means there's not even one. So when we say some students like disco, that means there's at least one. So that's how you negate a statement. The other thing I want to mention is notice all humans are mortal. That's a false statement. And some humans are not mortal. Oh, wait a second. I'm sorry. I just messed that up. That's actually true. We all are mortal. We all eventually do die. Some humans are not mortal. Now, that's not true. That would be the false statement. My point is, when you negate a statement, it's going to have the opposite truth value. If one's true, the other will be false. And so they're always going to have the opposite truth value. All right, and that's it for this lesson.